Learn how to migrate your MySQL database to Azure in this episode of Azure Tips and Tricks. I'm going to migrate my existing MySQL database to an Azure database for MySQL. There are many ways to do that, and I'll use MySQL Workbench to do it. To follow along, you need an existing MySQL database that can be accessed from Azure. If you don't have one, you can create a MySQL server in an Azure VM and run a SQL script with sample data, which you can find in the description of this video. You'll also need to install MySQL Workbench in a place that can access your existing database and Azure. All right, I'll start by creating an Azure database for MySQL Server in the Azure portal. Here it is. Create it. OK. First, I'll select Single Server. That's fine. All right. Now select a resource group. And next, fill in a server name. OK. And here, I'll put in a username for the server. And now also a password for it. And finally, confirm the password, like this. And OK, let's create it. I'll skip to when it is done. All right, here is the Azure database for MySQL. Before I can migrate data to it, I need to make sure that I can access it. Let's see here. This looks good. I don't deny public network access, and the Allow access to Azure services setting is enabled. All right, and you might also need to add your IP address to the firewall before it works for you. OK. Here I am in MySQL Workbench. This is running on my local machine, which is connected to my Azure subscription with an Azure ExpressRoute connection. Wherever your MySQL database is located, you need to make sure that it can connect to Azure. Let's connect to MySQL database. Here we go. This is the schema of the database. Let's take a look at the tables. And this one here. OK, there are lots of rows in the table. Cool. In here, you can go to Database and Migration Wizard. I can use this wizard to migrate my data. Let's start. First, this is my source database, my existing MySQL. All right, next. Now, let's add my Azure MySQL as a new connection. This is the host name for it, which you can find in the connection string blade of the server in the Azure portal. Now for the username. OK. And here, I'll put in the password. Here we go. Let's test the connection. Cool, that worked. And close it. So now we have the source and target. Next. All right. Now it will check the schema. Next. And here I will pick the schema to migrate. This one. OK, next. All right. Another check here. And all is well. Next. Let's see. I want to only migrate my tables and not my views. Cool. Next. Now it will create the SQL scripts for migration. OK, next. And this looks good as well. No warnings or errors. Next one. All right. I want to create the schema in the target Azure server. And next, here it goes, creating the schema. And the next one. Let's see. This looks good. Everything seemed to work. Here we go. I'll choose to do an online migration. I can also create a batch file or script to migrate the data later. Let's do it. Here it goes, migrating the data. All right, that's it. Let's see. That seems to have worked. Cool. Let's try that out. I'll connect to the Azure database server. Here we go. OK, here is the schema that is migrated. And these are the tables. All right, let's query it. And here are the rows of data that we migrated. That worked. When you migrate your MySQL database to Azure, you let Azure take care of running your database and making it highly available, secure, scalable, and performant, so that you can focus on building applications that add value. There are several options to migrate a MySQL database to Azure, and in this video, we saw one of them. You can use the Azure Database Migration Guide at this URL to choose the right option for you. Go and check it out.